I got a 90% on my exam. What is up, guys? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. What is good? What is poppin'? I don't think I'll ever get tired of saying that. But obviously you guys clicked on this video because you want to see how I study. This video is a long time coming. I don't feel like I studied that great my first semester of nursing school. And if you guys are new here, my name is Molly. I am now a semester 2, block 2 nursing student, and I am currently in my psych rotation. My first semester of nursing school, I probably averaged about an 84% on my exams, and it was a tough go. Story time. I failed my second exam in nursing school, like my second ever exam in nursing school, and it was one of the worst experiences, like, of my whole nursing school experience. I remember I was in the courtyard and it was so embarrassing because I broke down crying. I thought that I was a failure. I called my mom. I was like, I don't, and my mom's a nurse too, so she kind of gets it. And I remember I was just like feeling like I couldn't do it anymore. And that's when she told me, at least in nursing school, it's way harder, because in prereqs I went from having above 100% on all of my tests to averaging an 84%. So that was a really, really big reality adjustment for me. So I didn't want to make a video about how I studied too soon until I knew it was effective. And this morning, I had my very first psych exam with this study method, and I actually got the highest score I have ever received in nursing school. So I know that this is effective and I know that it works. What works for me. So if you guys want to just keep on watching and see how I do it, thank you. Also, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel, and also follow my Instagram for all of my stuff nursing related that you don't see on my channel, because there is a bunch. I post a lot regarding like nursing school and like all that kind of fun stuff, and you guys can reach out to me, ask me questions, or I can ask you guys questions, and we're just a big family. So thank you guys for watching. Okay, so I know that not every professor will hand out one of these, but what is so nice is that my professor actually gives us like a blueprint of what to expect for the exams. So like for the first exam, it broke it down by like how many questions are gonna be on each topic or chapter. So I knew that I really needed to focus on like mood disorders, as well as like assessment, all that kind of stuff, like depending on how many questions are going to be on the test. So for the sake of this video, I will show you guys how I am going to set up my whiteboard right here, based on the exam to blueprints that we have right here. Okay, so this is like the finished product of what is going to be on my second exam. I like to write it out like this because it allows me to see like exactly what I need to know, what's super important, and then also all the medications that I need to know for each disorder, since we are doing psych this time around. Also, it gives me like a clear expectation, and I put these little boxes too, like if you see next to the end, so I can check it off when I'm done. And then typically I'll erase the boxes and then I'll recheck them off to go over my material a second time. So this is how I set up my whiteboard. So what's really nice about my class is that the material is broken up into different weeks, so that we can get like, we can do the material like a week at a time. But what I like to do is like see how much is in that week, because see how I only have like a little bit to do in week 3. Obviously I'm gonna try and get some stuff done in week 4, that way I don't have week 4 as a ton. So when it comes to nursing school, a tip that I have for you guys is don't wait to learn the material when you get to class, because that is going to make you fall so far behind. You want to get, say if I have to start working on week 3, technically all that information is actually due tomorrow before we go to class. So I am a little bit behind on it because I did spend all that time just studying for my exam because I was freaking out about it. But yeah, if you stay up on top of your study game and get stuff done early, you can, you can spend that last week just going over the information again, and it's not new to you. That is like where you can get the information to stick. That's where you can start checking off your boxes. That is just, don't wait till the last minute, because that's how you really screw yourself over and you miss like the minor details in which they will form into an NCLEX style question and throw you off because you aren't confident. And that was me last semester, so don't do that. I also wanted to mention that because we are doing virtual online nursing school now, a lot of my PowerPoints are pre-recorded with information like if we were to go to class. So with that being said, how I typically study is I will open up a PowerPoint, I will listen to the PowerPoint, but it'll take me a lot longer to go through the PowerPoint the first time. If this is the case for you, I would definitely go through that PowerPoint at least 3 times before your exam day. And I say that because I think there's only like a 13% retention rate the first time you hear something. I don't know about that, but I know it's very, very low. So if you like continue like listening to your PowerPoints, the information will stick so much better. So let me show you what specifically I do. So this is like completely full of my first exam material. This thing is kind of like my Psych 1, Exam 1 Bible. There's a ton of information in here. I don't know why I decided to write out my entire study guide, but I did. This time around, you don't have to. I know OneNote is very good. I'm gonna try using OneNote this next time around. I think that I retain things better if I write them down and have it like right in front of me. But so basically, like while I am reviewing my lectures, I'll go through, and this is all the information that was in here. I'll go through and make a blueprint of what my exam one consists of, what PDFs I have to go over, what I have to do, and what I have to read in the textbook. So this is kind of like everything that I have to do, as you can see, I like checked everything off. And then these little tabbies I put on the side for like really important information that is mentioned that is going to be on the test. So like I can refer back to that, which I noticed did work this time around. So that was really cool. But basically I'll just go through and I'll point out all of the main ideas and highlight them in pink and like go through each PowerPoint and listen to what she has to say. Because a lot of the times when professors are, you know, teaching a class, they put things on the exam that aren't in the PowerPoints. And so what's nice about this online structure is I can go back and see what she had to say about a specific slide, which is why I really like this online learning format. And that's like a huge plus, because if I'm in class and I miss what she said and I didn't record the lecture, I'm just out of it. And then you have to share notes and you're worried you missed something. And then a question pops up and it just spirals down from there. So I really like to go back, and it looks like a lot, but like as I said, I will do these like little things, like things that she says, this is going to be on the test, or this is really important, you need to know this. That kind of stuff is what I will tabby on this side, and then everything else I'll only put if it's like super mentioned. But you can do this in OneNote too. You don't have to write it all out. I don't know why I did. I'm just crazy. Okay, also, if your class is like mine where pharmacology is kind of mixed in with,
your classes, like, for example, we don't just learn about all the medications and then go into the class. We kind of learn the medications as we are learning about, like, say, the mood disorder. So with addiction, we'll learn about addiction medications along with it, which I really like because it helps me remember more. But you can do this in OneNote too. Honestly, I don't know why I wrote out everything. I think it was just kind of like an ease for me that I didn't have to, like, I don't know. I'm probably not going to do this again, but either it's in the computer or it's on here. It's the same thing. But I like to make separate little kind of cheat notes. I don't really like the word cheat. Simple notes for each of my medications on what she went over, like what we have to know. And then I go off of that, and I made one for each. This exam had 30 medications on it, y'all. So there was a lot. But I just want to remember the main points that she pointed out about them. Luckily for this block, we don't have to know the dosages. We don't have to know, we only really needed to know the major side effects, their categories, and like what they can do to people and what their purpose is for. But yeah, I made these little med sheets so that I could go over them. And then this is the med sheet that we got, but having these like med sheet, like cheat sheet things that I made helped me so much. Like it helped me remember it way easier than just looking at it in the textbook or on the PowerPoint.
Hey guys, I just wanted to say thank you so much for watching my video, and if you liked it, go ahead and like, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Also, one thing that I wanted to let you guys know is my actual like exam routine that doesn't really involve, it's kind of wild. So everyone thinks that I'm crazy for doing this, but I like to study at night, and I find myself like, I'll study for about 6 hours the day before. I'll go through all the material and then I'll go to bed at like 10 p.m. But this is the crazy thing. I wake up at like 2:45, 3 o'clock in the morning to study again. And the reason why I do this is because I have such bad test anxiety that I can't sleep. So I figured, why not use that time where I can't sleep to go over the information again, to give myself reassurance so that I can do great on the test. And this, weirdly enough, like has worked for me. I did it this past test and the one before, and it really worked for me today. I mean, I took like a fat nap after I got done with the exam, but I find that it really works for me. I study until about 5:30. My test is usually 8 a.m. and then I make myself a big bowl of oatmeal and I take my test, call it a day, go to sleep. So that's what I like to do before my exams. Wow, I just lost my train of thought. But yeah, so thank you guys for watching this video. Don't forget to like it. Don't forget to subscribe. And happy fall, y'all.